could imagine a scenario where the Israelis legitimately, like, just tried to race out to get a narrative out there, got shit wrong, and it still wasn't them. That scenario is possible. But if somebody is publishing incorrect evidence, that's not good. It doesn't make your case stronger. It makes it a lot weaker. I will bring up the fact, though, and this still baffles me. Why has Palestinian Islamic Jihad or Hamas have yet to turn in or show to the international community or any investigators the shrapnel from the bomb? Why have they have yet to show that? Because it feels like that would be a strong piece of evidence. At this point, you know, it's been so long, I doubt they're going to do it. But that would be a strong piece of evidence if they had the shrapnel.
Because currently, while we're having this conversation, sieging the main hospital in Gaza, Israel, at that point, had 420 medical incidents, according to the World Health Organization. If you get your fucking news from clips, you are not going to understand why I said what I said, including that unless there is an actual third-party on-the-ground investigation, I will, of course, believe, given the circumstantial evidence mounted, that this is yet another Israeli bomb or some type of Israeli munitions, that I'm going to assume that, yes, Israel blew up this hospital just like they had blown up the cancer ward at that very same hospital 2 days prior. Did you see that part of the coverage? No, you didn't.
You know what you're doing right now, and this is what you just did, right? I criticized you for jumping to conclusions, right? Which, by the way, a lot of streamers didn't. A lot of new streamers didn't, right? I would have been down to make videos. Some did, but a lot didn't, right?
No, you wouldn't, dumbass. You only did this because it gets you fucking views. You don't care about Israel.
All you did was justify the bad stuff, justify why
Israel claimed that the BBC was doing modern blood libel.
This is what you just said. All you did right there was justify why you should be able to report things that way. And then you dismissed it all saying, well, Israel's attacking Gaza right now, so none of it matters if I got it wrong.
Because
it
doesn't matter.
It's fucking embarrassing.
Because the point that you're trying to argue here without actually saying it.
The point is that you should just wait and fucking do a good job reporting. Why were you coming to conclusions making
the
concrete statements you know nothing about? That's the same thing that's on.
I could have swore I remembered this. Tell me if I'm wrong, because I might be wrong. Did he at one point commit to not really doing breaking news anymore because he do breaking news coverage? Did he commit to that at one point? I could have swore he did. Maybe I'm just wrong. Maybe I'm misremembering something. He did? You know, I vaguely remember, but I'm scratching the vertebrae of my brain right now, trying to figure it out.
Okay.
I'm
gonna lose my fucking mind. Listen to me.
I'm losing my mind, bro.
He said on Piers Morgan that he has a principle of not covering breaking news. Gotcha.
First of all, you're holding to a fucking higher standard of the fucking BBC, which the Israeli government said was bloodline. You want to know why I didn't apologize? Do you care? Do you want me to tell you why I didn't apologize?
I know why you didn't apologize, because you never did. You always doubled down.
No, I don't apologize? That's crazy, because you said I never apologized about being wrong about Ukraine, but I did.
Yeah, and you lied
and said that, you were just backing away.
I'm very consistent with them.
You're consistently wrong, you dense fuck. Listen.
I haven't. You don't even watch the videos. How would you know if you're wrong?
Why would I watch these dumbass wrong performing videos? You don't give a shit.
There goes Chepo Boy.
You're gonna shit about this conflict beyond pushing your fucking personal. You watching my videos
is the same level of reporting that you give Israel and Gaza. It's the same level of reporting
Ukraine. I'm gonna be honest with you. You're revealing how stupid you are by claiming that watching a fucking YouTube video is the same as like reading news reports and talking to on the ground journalists and forensic analysts.
I'm saying you won't even do the bare minimum and you won't even do it for a drama video.
I'm losing my fucking mind. Why would I care about your drama video, dumb fuck?
Yeah, you do. That's why you invited me on.
And I invited you on. I invited you on because I thought that you genuinely had a perspective that was at odds with mine on Israel-Palestine. You said, never mind, it's not what we're going to talk about. We're going to talk about my videos that I've made on you. So now, we're stuck having this fucking stupid conversation. Willie,
is this how Hassan?